consists of sometimes translating from English into Japanese, but you know, most of the activities are based in Japanese. So, you know, that's why the Japanese universities have failed utterly in catching up with the, you know, progress in the world, which is based in the lingua franca of English, right? So, you know, and so I did excellently in the Japanese education system. I was a top student. Really, I mean, by any measure adopted by the Japanese English education system, I was always at the very top. I can testify that, you know. I did okay. That's why I entered the University of Tokyo, for example. But, you know, when I was 20, I went to the U.S., attending, participating in a conference called the Japan-America Students Conference, JASC. It's, you know, about 40 Japanese students visited American university campuses and also the headquarters of General Motors. And we also went to New York to visit the Amnesty International headquarters there. And that's when I was exposed to the brutal, you know, world of English that people actually speak. And it, you know, it was really hard to, you know, be among American university students on the campus. You know, we were, you know, drinking beer, and you know, they would keep talking about American culture and so on. Some of the names I didn't catch because I was not kind of familiar with the American culture. But then at the same time, these students talked about the world, right? I mean, the world that the American university students, like the students from Harvard, Stanford, Caltech, these students, the world, the extension of the world that these students were seeing was entirely different from the extent of the world that Japanese university students were seeing. For example, if you go to the law department of the University of Tokyo, right, that's considered to be the elite institution here, because it produces a lot of government bureaucrats. You know, they talk something like, and if you go to into the Ministry of Finance, how many, you know, then you would be head of the tax office in a rural area after 2 years, and then you can get married to the daughter of a very wealthy local person. And then when you're 60, you can retire, and you know, in Japanese, it's called amakudari, right? I mean, you can get a very lucrative job in a government-funded organization or that kind of stuff. At the age of 20, believe it or not, the students at the University of Tokyo Law Department are talking this kind of nonsense. Whereas, you know, if you meet somebody from Harvard or in Yale, they're talking about the world. The job you know, prospects are much wider. You know, they're talking about whether we should go, I should go to Australia to do something, or, you know, this. Because once you can be, you are able to speak English, I mean, if it is a lingua franca, yeah, you can see much broader world, right? But just because the Japanese English education system has been designed to rather contain us, right? I mean, the Ministry of Education and Science, they don't want us to go out to the United States to study, because that would be the disaster for them, right? Because there would be less talented students entering Japanese universities. So it's a conspiracy theory. I mean, it's no, I mean, when I say conspiracy theory, I mean, it's I sound like a nut, right? But but you know, yeah, well, it's really I you know, the Japanese university education is designed to contain, I mean, to kind of enclose the excellent Japanese students from, you know, and so that they are preventing us from going out and also being exposed to the wider world. So, you know, as I said, you know, I did okay with Japanese English education system, but when it comes to the task of really making it in the English-speaking world, it's going to be much, much harder. But I'm trying that. As a scientist, I also, of course, I write papers, but that's very different from writing a book on your own, exposing, you know, putting out ideas that might be worth spreading. That's a tall order for the typical Japanese scholar. That's why. Yeah, have you ever heard, you know, if you watch TV, You see all these university professors of Tokyo, from Tokyo or Kyoto, and have you ever heard any, you know, university professor publishing a book in English and making a splash in the broader world? Never. These are domestic people, right? No matter how pompous they might appear, the only market for them is here, in this country. If these guys go to the United States, nobody knows them, right? And so I think, you know, I was kind of being a little bit carried away, as always, I mean, because when I talk about these things, I tend to be kind of volcanic. Anyway, sorry. To get back to my original point, I think, you know, from in the future, I think it would be a very good idea for anybody studying English in this country to aspire to give a talk at TED someday. I think that would be a very good benchmark. You can start from scratch. You can probably start from a TEDx event and gradually make it to TED Grover or TED Long Beach, you know. I think that would be a very good way to measure your English ability. When I'm saying, you know, because the reason why I'm saying this is because in order to give a talk, good talk at TED, you have to have an idea as well as, you know, being able to speak English. You know, there are certain trends in the Japanese university system where actually people are starting to educate students in English. There are some universities already based on the liberal arts model of the American universities. However, yeah, actually, I have taught in these newly emerging universities myself. However, probably because it's a transitional period, the academic standards of students at these institutions are not particularly high. So there's a trade-off. It's a very sad trade-off. You know, on the other hand, you have academically very excellent students, but they have been a victim. They have been victims of the Japanese education system, where English is mainly about translation. So you have these students at, you know, University of Tokyo, Keio, Waseda, and so on. On the other hand, they are newly emerging institutions where they base their entire education in English. That is good. However, the academic standards are still catching up. So we...